sharing us Japanese secret. Actually, Japan MOOC is very interesting. The consortium is so strong and started from private sectors, not from the government. And as he said, the way to sustain it is very difficult. There should be a way to deal with it. So thank you so much for sharing this with us, sir. Thank you. But anyhow, anyone would like to ask him a question? We have time for one quick question, please. And let me say this. We have two orange books from UNESCO. It will be given away to anyone who asks the question first. It could be this session or next session. Any taker? Counting down, 3, 2, 1, okay. Thank you for your presentation. That means he presented so clear, no questions. Thank you, sir. Okay, let's move on to our next session, still track number 2. We will learn more from JMOOC on platform and portal level. And to start this session, may I please invite our lovely moderator, Professor Dr. Yoshimi Fukuhara. Professor Yoshimi Fukuhara is currently Secretary General of JMOOC. He is also a professor at Meiji University. When I talk about open consortium in open courseware in Japan, or I talk about MOOC in Japan, everybody there know him. So please join me to welcome him in a big hand. Thank you.
Thank you for kind introduction. From here, about 1 hour, we'd like to share the activity of the activity related on the platform portal level from the representative of various Asian countries. I'd like to introduce the first speaker. Could you please make the presentation 15 minutes each, please? Okay? So time is very limited, so please thank you for your cooperation. I'd like to introduce the first speaker of this session, President Professor Dr. Melinda Dela Pena Bandalaria, is this okay? She's president of AAOU and UPOU, and they're from, she's from Philippines. So the Professor Melinda, please.
Good afternoon, everyone, and I would like first to thank the organizers of this summit for giving me this opportunity to share with you what we've been doing. This is a very challenging part of the day, keeping the audience awake. and at the UP Open University where I came from, we're doing mostly online courses. This is what we say. For online courses, our students can choose the time that they will engage in the course content. And in most cases, they will avoid this time of the day. So it's really a challenge for professors to keep the learners engaged during the afternoon part of the day. For this afternoon, I am actually wearing two hats. As introduced, I am also representing here the Asian Association of Open Universities, where the Philippines is currently the president. Our term took effect last January 1, 2017. I am also representing here the University of the Philippines Open University, where I came from. I am the current chancellor of the university, And our university is the only one at the higher education institution offering MOOCs in the Philippines. And hopefully in the process of my presentation, while I will be focusing more on the initiative of the Asian Association of Open Universities, I hope I can also, in some ways, share with you our initiatives at the UP Open University in offering what I term as, we have the KMOOC, we have the JMOOC, and I think March 1 was a very historical day for the Thai MOOC. I have read that yesterday the first MOOC, is that correct? It was an inaugural thing for the Thai MOOC. In the Philippines, we call it the PMOOC, following the tradition of JMOOC, KMOOC, Thai MOOC. We also have the PMOOC. Actually, when I first called it PMOOC, I was actually referring to pedagogical MOOC. Yes, when we first started offering MOOCs in 2013, I was asked by some of our colleagues, will it be XMOOC? Will it be CMOOC? And I said, neither. Let's look at the pedagogy and using mostly what we have learned from offering online courses, this time making it open. So my presentation, as I have mentioned, will focus more on the Asian MOOC portal. This is an initiative of the Asian Association of Open Universities, AAOU. Some of you are members of the Asian Association of Open Universities. There are currently 63 members of that association. 45 members are regular members, and 18 are associate members. But not all of these institutions are offering MOOCs. There are only a number of member institutions offering MOOCs, so I'm hoping that soon we will be able to ask other institutions to offer their own MOOC through the Asian MOOC portal, which we have at the moment. Okay, I titled my presentation Asian MOOC Portal, the Model, Governance, Sustainability, Plans, and Challenges. Okay. So what is it that we call the Asian MOOCs? These are the MOOCs offered by the member institutions of the Asian Association of Open Universities. The Asian MOOC portal, we call ourselves the steering committee. Okay. So the Asian MOOC portal, this organization, this association is coordinated specific for the Asian MOOC by a steering committee with membership from Hong Kong, Indonesia, India, Japan, Malaysia, Philippines, and Vietnam. And the purpose of this getting together is to encourage, support, and assist the members of the Asian Association of Open Universities to join in and share their MOOCs metadata. So it's not actually us getting the MOOCs from our member institutions, but for us to just have something of a landing page for the MOOCs that our member institutions offer. These are our taglines in our Asian MOOCs portal. We say that this is our gateway to knowledge, our gateway to borderless education, and open access to knowledge and education. So this is what we are really advocating. We are hoping that through this portal and through the collaboration of those member institutions, we can really offer these courses not only to the member institutions, but also to the world. At AAOU, our tagline is also advocating or educating the world through Asia. And this is what we are also hoping that we can accomplish in this summit that we are holding today. thing. I'm just waiting for the queue. I cannot control it from where I am. Okay, so the Asian MOOCs portal is an integrated hub for providing MOOCs information, support, and other value-added services to potential learners. It links up MOOCs, or massive open online courses, of AAOU member institutions together to promote and facilitate the offering of MOOCs. So what we are saying is that through the portal that the Asian MOOCs has and we developed, we are increasing the visibility of the massive open online courses of those institutions who are joining this portal. So promote courses, reach out to more learners, showcase their MOOCs in an international platform to the global world on the mutually beneficial terms. We are also aiming to advance and promote openness and innovations in education. We are assisting our member institutions in developing their MOOCs, and of course, we are advocating open education through our own offering of the massive open online courses. We are looking at MOOCs, positioning our MOOCs really as our structure to support lifelong learning initiatives. As what has been mentioned this morning, lifelong learning has been tagged as a very important component of the sustainable development goals. And we are hoping that through the Asian MOOCs portal that we have developed, we are supporting, providing structures so that we could provide more learning, lifelong learning opportunities to not only to those who are in Asia, but also to the rest of lifelong learners in the world. This is a screenshot of the Asian MOOCs portal. We have data from 39 MOOCs from 9 open universities. We are still in the process of developing it. We just launched it last year in Manila, last October in Manila. And we are still in the process of providing information and getting other member institutions to provide us with information about their MOOCs. As you can see here, this is one page wherein there is a link to the MOOCs offered by OUJ and one course from OUJ and some of the courses offered by the UP Open University. As a member institution of this Asian MOOC portal, UP Open University is sharing some of the 40, we have developed so far 46 MOOCs, but not all of them will be shared at this point. So we are still in the process of curating or evaluating in terms of the quality aspects before we can share these MOOCs in this portal. So that's how we are doing things now. So these links, like for instance, one course here from the UP Open University is Art in the ASEAN region. If you will click that link, then it will bring you to the course itself, the course which is contained in our own platform. So the platform of the university is retained, as in the case of UP Open University, and learners who are interested to enroll in these courses will be directed to that learning platform. So the next slide will show the information about the specific course. Okay. Unfortunately, I don't have a copy of my presentation, so I have to rely on the... Okay, I think I have to have the previous slide. that one. Okay. So some of the information that we are gathering from the participating institutions include the title of the course, what language, and of course the date of offering, the schedule of offering the courses. We are now still in the process of gathering those information from the member institutions, and we are still in the process of putting in place the harvester for the metadata, so that we will no longer have to do it manually. So we have to look into the different plugins that are now available, and we can work on automating the data gathering for the Asia MOOC portal. Okay, so as I have mentioned, the Asian MOOC portal is the landing page for the MOOCs offered by partner institution. It was launched on 26 October 2016 in Manila. Learners are directed to the site of the MOOC. The QA of MOOCs included in the Asian MOOC portal should subscribe to the QA framework for MOOC established by AAOU. So we are now in the process of doing two major research for the Asian MOOC that we are offering. One is on the quality QA framework, and the other research is on the transfer credit. So the research on these two aspects are still ongoing. And I'm also happy to note that some of the member institutions of the steering committee are also here with us today. And like Indonesia, for instance, and Professor Yamada of OUJ, they are the ones involved in putting together the Asian MOOC portal. While the Philippines and Vietnam and Hong Kong, we are working on the transfer credits for our MOOCs. Can we go to slide? Okay, so as I have mentioned, the transfer credits being studied. In terms of sustainability and challenges, we are looking at, since this is a service to AAOU member institutions, the offering of MOOCs will be supported by the Asian Association of Open Universities. And one of the things that we are planning to do now is to do another survey for the AAOU institutions in terms of updating who are the other institutions offering their MOOCs now and who are interested to join and put their MOOCs in the Asian MOOC portal. The challenges, we have experienced this. Since there is no dedicated staff to focus on the work, we find the development of the portal, harvesting of data, and inviting other member institutions to be quite a slow process. And this is also something that we hope we can do something about this 2017, because we really need to move this forward. In addition to the two research initiatives that we have initiated in 2016. We are hoping that there will be more institutions to be to join this 2017. We also observed that among the member institutions, there is also this preference to offer their MOOCs through the big course MOOC providers like Coursera, edX, or Udacity. So it may be a challenge for the Asian MOOCs to invite other institutions to load their MOOCs through the Asian MOOC portal. But then again, probably through more advocacy, through explaining why we are doing these things for Asia, then we can still convince other institutions to join us. The target for 2017 is the completion of the two research projects, and probably up to 50 MOOCs to be offered through the Asian MOOC portal. So the other institutions will be invited. I have discussed this with other member institutions already, and we are hoping that we can share this portal to the rest of the Asia-Pacific institutions who are interested to offer their MOOCs through this platform. So I think that's all. I was given, I think in the instruction, I was given only 10 minutes to present my, yes. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Dr. Melinda. And next presenter, I'd like to introduce the Associate Professor Dr. Alyani Ismail. Okay, it's correct. She is Deputy Director, Teaching and Learning Innovation Center for Academic Development, and also University Putra, Malaysia, and the chair Lady Malaysia MOOC Working Committee, Minister of Higher Education Malaysia, Chairman Malaysia E-Learning Council for Public University. Okay, please.
Very good afternoon to all of you. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you for the invitation on behalf of the Malaysians. On behalf of Malaysians, I would like to say thanks for the invitation. And perhaps from this platform, we will continue our collaborations within the Asia-Pacific region. As you can see from the instruction, thank you, Professor, for introducing me. I'm also wearing many hats. But one of the hats that I wear today that I'll be presenting on behalf of the Malaysia MOOC Working Committee, which is under the Ministry of Higher Education Malaysia, and also on behalf of the Malaysia E-Learning Council for Public Universities. Malaysia MOOC has been launched since 2015, but before that, there are a number of universities that have actually taken initiatives on their own to produce MOOCs. But the branding of Malaysia MOOCs is actually the work of collaboration between 20 public universities, and this is the national initiatives by Malaysia to actually bring up the e-learning into another stage that we can actually be proud of. Yep. Okay, so perhaps this work, Malaysia MOOC, is not the work of one university alone. As I mentioned, it's a collaboration between 20 universities coordinated by the Malaysia MOOC Working Committee under the Ministry of Higher Education, as well as coordinated by the Malaysian National E-Council for Public Universities. Yeah, can we have that? Sure. I also come from a university called University Putra, Malaysia, which is located nearby Putrajaya. So hopefully, if you have time to visit Malaysia, do come to our university. Yeah. I'm just waiting for the slides to come up, actually. I'm going to touch a bit on how we started with Malaysia MOOC, where the platform, what are the platform that we use, as well as how the interactions are happening in the platform. Okay, that one, Bangkok, yeah. Yes. Okay, so this is the overview of MOOC development in and implementation in Malaysia, and why MOOC. I don't have to explain to you why do we use MOOCs, right? So it is an open education initiatives that we as Malaysian have taken a step ahead to reach the global community. Yeah. So I just. So it looks better now. I can control it from here. Right. I think it's okay, right? Yeah, I just move on. Okay, Malaysia MOOCs, this is one of the things that we want to see, is to bring Malaysia as Open Education Initiatives Hub to the global community. And we have actually put up MOOCs as one of our key areas. We call it SHIFT in our Malaysian Higher Education Blueprint from 2015 to 2025, as shift number 9, we call it, in the globalized online learning platform. So this is one of our shift in the Malaysian Education Blueprint, is to enhance the quality of teaching and learning, bringing niche area to global arena, visibility, positioning and branding, as well as lifelong learning. And this is the frameworks that we use in Malaysia MOOCs. It is a very structured, collaborative movement to bring the Malaysian education to global arena. And as you can see there, we use input process output approach, whereby at the end of the day, what we want to see as the objectives are to improve teaching and learning, as well as lifelong learning. As I mentioned, Malaysia MOOC is a collaboration between 20 public universities to produce courses in these three categories. One of the categories is common courses between universities, whereby the MOOCs are selected from the compulsory courses between the 20 universities. At Malaysian universities, we have compulsory courses such as Asian and Islamic civilization courses, which is compulsory for all the public university students to take. So we kind of share these resources together within 20 universities by developing the course online by MOOCs, and every student in our institutions can enroll for free, as well as public students, public learners, they can enroll these courses for free. And another category is on niche courses, whereby we introduce courses which is showing the niche of Malaysian universities. Like my university, Universiti Putra Malaysia, is actually agricultural-centered university. Therefore, we have many courses on agriculture. Some of the universities are focusing on medical subjects, and these are coordinated by the National E-Council committees, as well as the Malaysian Higher Education Ministries, where we vet all these courses according to the niche of the universities. And we have also one category which is very important category, which is the lifelong learning or skills courses. Like we have a course on water safety, swimming, food, Malaysia food heritage. So these are the courses that will attract more public learners to come and join the courses. Recently, in 2017, our minister, Ministry of Higher Education, have actually launched guidelines on credit transfer MOOCs, using MOOCs for credit transfer between the universities. And we are in the process of redesigning Malaysian higher education. If you search in YouTube, I don't have time to show it here. If you search in YouTube on redesigning Malaysian higher education, you will see a YouTube video that has been prepared to show what will be our future direction. In sum, we are heading towards flexible education, whereby the concept of jukebox. Do you know jukebox? It's kind of a music buffet. You can choose music, for example. You can choose your own subjects you want to study. So you become the owner of. You become more empowered to choose your own subjects and be awarded programs based on the subjects that you choose. This is the future direction. And Malaysia MOOC research report has been published through these links. If you want to find the links, it's freely available to be downloaded in PDF files. Evaluation of Malaysia pilot MOOC. We actually launched our pilot Malaysia MOOCs in 2015. Four courses, four pioneer courses. We have done studies on it. Studies like students' perception, lecturers' perception, developers' perception, and what kind of media that the students would like to have, videos, and their feedbacks are reported in these links. So this is the platform that we use, openlearning.com. This is a work together by Open Learning from Australia, based in Australia, and with the Ministry of Higher Education to park our courses. So all the courses from the 20 public universities you can find from these links, openlearning.com/MalaysiaMOOCs, and it is free for anybody. It's free for all, but we are moving towards for paid courses to get it certified. Once you decide to get a certification, then we will charge. But it's freely available for you to access anytime. Yeah. These are the public universities that we are working together. And this is a screenshot of the Malaysia MOOC platform, Open Learning platform, which is, there is a page dedicated to Malaysia MOOCs. Okay. Statistics, four pioneer courses launched in 2014, actually. Some of them are in 2015. We have total enrollments for this. These are all compulsory courses for Malaysian students. Yeah. These are the start of the four pioneer courses, Islamic Civilization and Asian Civilization, Integration and Ethnic Relation in Malaysia, Introduction to Entrepreneurship, and ICT Competency. As you can see, these courses are offered by different universities, but we come together as a team. So far, Malaysian public universities, there are 20, and total number of MOOCs produced up to date is 219. Actually, when we first started, we put a target of 3 courses per year by each university. So by the end of the year, we will get 60 MOOCs per year. But we exceed that target. And now, within 2 years, we have produced 290 courses which are available online. However, the total enrollments as of now is 218,000, more than 200,000, because these courses are still new, and most of the courses are just offered in September last year. So it's just these courses are still new. This is a social learning platform. That means we have resources. We put up the resources. The knowledge will grow from there. It's social learning based, and up to the certification if the students choose to get certification. It's good that Open Learning, the company that we work in, has an office in Malaysia, Open Learning Malaysia. And when we first started, we started with MOOC 1.0, and we worked together with platform openlearning.com to cater for our needs. So when we first started, the platform is quite a normal, basic, structured platform. But as we moved on with Malaysia MOOCs, Open Learning has taken our feedbacks to produce the platform to more advanced states. Rather than just putting resources, we have the ability to do learning analytics as well as putting activities online. So it's not just based on resources. This is a student-centered learning platform whereby, as you know, passive learning is just looking at videos and readings and doing corrective learning, something like quizzes, MCQ. But these are the lower side. But we have gone further up to socially constructive approach in students' learning. And delivering the MOOC, this is TITAS. TITAS is the Islamic and Asian Civilization course, which is offered in Bahasa because it's compulsory for all our students to take. Sharing of learning materials, that means it cut across 20 universities. One university is responsible to create the course, but the learning materials can be shared in the platform from all over the world. And the students' response, discussions on real case scenario and current issues, this is beyond their contents. So now you are putting social learning into perspective, whereby students are sharing things online. And comment beyond contents as well. This is about, hang out, cool, be adventurous, and so on. It's beyond civilization talks. And students share their activities on projects they have done, because the way we devise our learning materials, we devise also learning activities in such a way the students share their activities on projects. This is one example of the courses, social media and learning. We call it SMILE. This is from UKM, another university. This is how it looks like in the portal, the modules in the portal. Yeah, this is the comments from the students. The students can share their materials, what they do, what are the outcomes of the activities they can share in the gallery. These are active participations, as we call it, social learning, social participation. You have one piece of video, for example, or you have one piece of resource, and these resources grows as they share materials, other materials, and they give comments based on the materials and activities that they have done. All the learning activities, they can track their progress, which activities that they have done. These are all the list of activities that they have. They can track the progress, whether or not they have started the activities or not, or whether they have finished. And this is the National E-Learning Committees Council that we work together with Open Learning to provide training and support for our MOOC developers, as well as those who deliver the course. In our MOOCs, not only one university, lecturers from one university deliver the course, but the course can be co-teached by the lecturers from other universities, where openlearning.com has actually functions to invite co-teachers. And I would like to promote this carnival, International University Carnival on Learning, which is coming on 26 and 27 September 2017 in Malaysia. All of you are invited to join this carnival, where we have competitions, we have awards, we have presentations, and evolve international. I would like to personally invite all of you to join us at this carnival. And last but not least, I would like to say thanks, and I would like to say this. We, at our national level, we have had many trainings conducted, and we have been trainers to a number of international universities. Like in the Philippines, we are the trainers for MOOCs and blended learning, as well as education in technology for the Asian Association of Agricultural College and Universities. They have joined our training sessions at UPM for 2 years in a row. So I would like to invite all of you, if you need trainers as well as training packages on MOOCs, blended learnings, or learning technologies, you can contact me and we will arrange training sessions as you wish. Thank you very much.
Thank you for a very nice presentation, Dr. Alyani. And sorry for inconvenience from machine travel. Maybe next we can continue, I think, I hope. Next presenter is from Korea, Director Whan Choi, National Institute of Lifelong Education. So, Dr. Choi, please.
Good afternoon. Afternoon, we feel so sleep. I finished it quickly, as very quickly, as soon as possible. My name is Wutiwiwatchai, director of JMOOC system of an operating building system. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to presentation. Sorry, but I am not good at speaking English. Could you any question on data or communication, send to me, email for me. I'm discussion of three points. One is JMOOC system, massive open online courseware in Nile. First, we consider the make the MOOC system, how we make the MOOC system. System integration by SI project, new development, or using open source. Then we consider the open source and compare the module on or OpenEdX. Module is a platform focused on private small learning system, learning space. OpenEdX is the focus on massive open online courseware and new technology on communicate. We decide to open edX. Last year we upgrade the KMOOC platform, KMOOC platform. To develop the KMOOC system over 3 or 4 months, but upgrade is over 6 months. This upgrade is longer than initial development. Initial version is Cypress, upgrade version is Eucalyptus. Upgrade is very difficult coursework because only few companies using the edX platform maintenance. Therefore, we need IT development community in Asia MOOCs and communicate on problem and solving IT technique. This is the system architecture of KMOOC system. This is on in IT focus, and I skip this. Currently, KMOOC service and using OpenEdX, and last year we upgrade LMS, CMS. We now letting open insight. We opened last month. We opened the mobile app. Next, we KMOOC mobile app. KMOOC mobile system is opened 1 month ago. iOS is opened only 2 days. This is Android App Store and KMOOC. This point is very, very high. Okay. Only 10 days, download count is 1,000 and almost people using this. Then download people is currently using the app. This is the KMOOC mobile app and my KMOOC mobile app courseware. This is login screen. This is a course menu. And this is the learning activities on quiz and problem. This is the video service and download service. Special KMOOC mobile app is benefit is offline video scan. Next, KMOOC Insight. edX Insight is installed in now in KMOOC server, but now the Nile is the testing the data and data convention and conversion and processing ongoing. We think it's scheduled on about on end of May. KMOOC Insight system is opened. This is the Insight screen, video playback point. I don't know the video, and video playback, and listen again. This is the right answer and wrong answer. Green point is right answer and wrong answer. Which answer is right answer or wrong answer? Learning activities on video. In green point, students and 55% and listened. Then finish the course. This is KMOOC in 2057. We considered this year cloud service and authentication. This is just Nile planned the cloud KMOOC cloud service in this year. Three cloud service model: traditional IT, infrastructure only service, platform cloud service, all cloud service. All cloud service named SaaS, software as a service called SaaS, for example, Amazon. KMOOC cloud service, we consider the start the infrastructure as a service. Then we develop the platform as a service. This is the 2B model and system architecture. This is the database and private area. And this is this area using private factor and private cloud service. And this green line and this blue line is changed the red line. Red line means the public cloud service. We changed the this year the red line service, public cloud service. And this is on authentication of KMOOC. This is the title of the course, and this is the name of the student. We changed the document security. One is watermarking, and one is real name service. KMOOC service is using the university credit. This service is more useful the university credit. Future plan, KMOOC future plan is one is the upgrade is very difficult, then we stabilization or stabilization rather than upgrade. And number two is big data analysis. We consider the students' learning analysis. And this IT technology is big data analysis and big data analysis model. And another is community on open edX or learning analyst group. We can this community group is developed to the other MOOCs. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to present. If you have any question or data, any more discussion of system, please email to me. Thank you.
Thank you very much for a very nice presentation, Dr. Choi. And final presentation of this session will be Dr. Choi, Wutiwiwatchai. So please, he's the national from National Electronics and Computer Technology Center, Thailand. Please.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, and good afternoon, everyone. I am again. May I introduce a little bit about myself? I am Chai from the National Electronics and Computer Technology Center under the Ministry of Science and Technology of Thailand. NECTEC, in short, NECTEC is taking care on developing the platform. What someone say portal. For the Thai MOOC, we have the system running on thaimooc.org right now. That's really beginning of Thai MOOC system. I can say that we just only less than 1 year experience now on MOOC. But what I would like to say is that we are express train, and we are going to have a very big. Number of classes within this year. Step to my presentation, PDF one. Actually, I would like to say about a little bit about the background and then the system architecture and the current status. Even we have only, it's okay now. NECTEC had experience in what we call distance learning television, which is a countrywide e-learning system. Before the coming of MOOC, before the coming of e-learning, we tried to distribute courses, high school courses from one school to the distance schools. Under the ministry, under His Majesty the King initiative. At that time, I think more than 10 years now, we broadcast the course through the satellite TV. And then we convert our satellite TV programs into digital format. And store it in the website, and we call it electronics DLTV, EDLTV. This is very popular one because right now we have about 300,000 requests per day. Per day. That's a really big system. But again, this is not a MOOC. So we experienced that. And then that's why we taking care on developing the MOOC for thaimooc.org. Okay, I have not necessary to say about the growth of the MOOC. So we skip from e-learning, LMS system, CMS system, to MOOC system. And at the beginning, maybe about 3 years ago, that I began to study about MOOC system, I heard about two things. One is MOOC, another one is Open Educational Resources, OER. And this is examples of the left one is the example of a very popular OER system called MEROT. I think this is very important in the beginning of having the open resources available on the internet, because people try to build the courses, but we are not care much about the copyright of the use of resources. So Creative Commons for the images, for the video clips, for everything that you are going to use it in the course construction is very important. That's why we start with the open educational resources and then going to MOOC. Now I can show you really brief introduction to the system architecture. Before the coming of Thai MOOC under Thailand Cyber University, we also have had another experience on developing the first MOOC under the Princess Mahachakri Sirinthorn Celebrate projects. Okay, this is this was 2 year projects since 2015 to 2016, but this is under the support of the Office of Basic Education Commission, not the Office of Higher Education Commission. We start with 10 initiative content partners, basically from the science and technology education viewpoint. Then we build the first MOOC system under the OBEC, okay, the Basic Educational Commission. Our system start with the connection of the first OER of Thailand with the MOOC that we developed based on OpenEDX. Very simple. And we connect it together. We try to make the course authoring tools easier so that the teachers in distant schools can start to build their own courses easily. Then you know that the OpenEDX is not easy for people with less computer literacy to use it. So we are thinking about the use, the development of the course authoring tool to be easier. We try to push, to convince teachers in the school to build their courses on the on our system by having the e-portfolio system, exporting the author's portfolio, like a CV of the teachers. So the teacher who participate in building the course or building the open educational resources in our system will have that certified on the CV. We just finished building the test bank. So it's a pool of the tests, okay? And all of these are under the Central Authentication Service, CS. So we can make a single sign-on access to every system. That's the system for OBEC. Based on this one, last year, we have a chance to extend this system to OHEC, okay, Office of Higher Education Commissions, and we accept more features that request by the thaimooc.org, starting by, you can see from the slides here. The first one is we are worrying about the video streaming, so we people try to store their video on YouTube, right, and use the facility from YouTube to help in video streaming, so you do not have any problems of video streaming even when the number of people access to your courses. But sometime we would like to build also our own video streaming servers to store our courses as a backup. So we build the video streaming under this requirement. We extend the test bank to the e-testing system. Now we are, you can think about the TOEFL kinds of things that you ask people to, students to gather and make the examination together. But now the system is really, we expect that the system will be really available for making the examination online, but together, you know. So this one is ongoing, and the another one is credit bank. Okay, to be honest, we are learning about the policy of using of building this credit bank. For me, the authentication service is really important for that one. So we are in the process of building these two systems, okay, into our existing system, and the less we are already done it. So you can see that this I show the status that this green star means we already have that, and that's the current features of thaimooc.org. We are building the video streaming and test bank. We already have that CAS. I show you a little bit about the each component. The open educational resources, we already learned it separate at oer.learn.in.th. Now we have quite a plenty number of open educational resources at up to 40,000 pieces of resources. So it's all Creative Commons, so everyone can access to this OER and access and use it. We built the OER based on Federal Commons open sources. So this one is available also for the to be a plugin of the Microsoft Office as well. For MOOC, we start from the Open EDX, just like everyone. I can skip this quickly. Open EDX, and then we have thaimooc.org developed from this one. We have the sandbox for people, for teacher to test creating the courses before moving this into the operation server. We have the development side, and we are building more and more features into this development system. The first one is that I talk about the authoring tools of the EDX is not easy. So we are thinking about like air ticket reservation step by step easier. So we built that one already. The second one, this is maybe a specific problem for Thai, that we have a plenty of SCORM-based courses. And one requirement is that how can we make use of that existing courses based on the SCORM system. So we have built another X-Block of the EDX to import the SCORM into EDX already. So we already have that, and we support from SCORM 1.2 until the current SCORM edition. and we connect the EDX with Fedora Commons OER by introducing what we call FedEx API. And this is already published in one international journal if you are interested in. And we are planning to open source this one for the open EDX community. So the last, today is really good because I have a chance to talk about, to talk with many people who will help me thinking about the features of credit banks and also e-testing system. So thank you really much for the organizer to let me know many people today. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Chow. Chai. Maybe you may have the, you may want to ask the question for the four nice presenter, but unfortunately, time has run out. So, please ask individually to the each presenter. So, lastly, I'd like to ask you to again the give the big applause for the presenter. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Professor Yoshimi. But stay tuned, we are going to have 15